Hi guys, my name's Amy. Today I'm going to talk about the difference between running a chip and spinning a chip. I have a 58 degree wedge here. I'm going to be using just this one wedge to show you the two different shots. The first shot I'm going to show you is a spinning chip. So basically, I'm going to put a little bit extra check on it. So once it lands, it's going to stop more so it doesn't run away from you. Basically, a couple things you have to do differently is when you set up the ball position, it's going to be like a golf ball, more left than usual. So it's going to be up in the stance. And when you hit the chip, you're going to kind of finish at the golf ball, feels like, okay? The momentum is obviously going to make you finish through a little bit, but you're gonna pretend like you're gonna hit and stop right at the golf ball. All right, let's try. So you go, boom. You see how that popped up pretty high and actually checked pretty good and stopped immediately? So basically what happens is if you put the ball up in your stance, you're gonna get a little bit more loft on your club head, so it's going to pretend like it's like a 60 degree wedge instead of a 58. So it's going to fly a little higher, land a little softer, and because I'm kinda hitting down on it and stopping at the golf ball, it's going to give it a little more zip so it rides up the groove a little more and put a little extra backspin on it. All right, so I don't know if you noticed, but the swing size right here, the backswing was twice as big as the downswing, approximately. So it goes 2-to-1 ratio of the backswing and downswing. Remember those 3 points. And to run the chip shot with the same club, basically what you do is in the setup, you have to put the golf ball back in your stance. I would say maybe a golf ball or two right over your regular chip shot ball position. And then what that's gonna do is it's going to de-loft the club head. So it's going to make that 58 degree into somewhere between 54 degrees or so. It's going to make the ball come out a little lower than usual, and it's going to run out a little bit more. Another thing you have to do here is that instead of kind of hitting it regular, you have to kind of push through or brush through the ball a little better. So there's more momentum to the target, so it runs out a little bit better. Watch. You see how my left hand was leaning a little bit more on this shot, different than the first shot I showed you? So if you lead with your wrist through a little better, it's easier to brush through. And as far as the swing size goes, with this one, let's say the backswing is about 1, downswing is about 1.5 times bigger. So it goes 1-to-1.5. Okay, so just remember those couple points I showed you. And before I finish up the lesson here, I want to give you one more tip to minimize your mistakes in chipping. If you always do these two things in chipping, you're always going to have a very consistent chip shot. So basically what you do, number one, is you have to pick if you're going to put a little spin on it or if you're going to run it. You have to promise yourself if you're gonna hit down or you're going to brush through, right? Number two, you have to pick your swing size. You have to promise yourself if you're gonna do 2-to-1 ratio or 1-to-1.5. I know these sound very basic, but it really makes a difference if you think it through first and then execute. So from now on, I'm going to expect you guys to be able to control your chip shot just like that. I hope you're able to follow along. If you like the lesson, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I'll see you in the next lesson.